Introduction to data analysis. Let's first take a brief look at the learning objectives. We want to keep these learning objectives in mind as we're going throughout this first section, which will actually encompass several videos. The purpose of the learning objectives is you need to make sure that you get this out of the videos or out of the particular chapter that you're actually working in. Now, the first thing we want to talk about is we want to develop an understanding of the basic terminology that's used in statistics. This is extremely important because I will be using these terminologies throughout the video. Your instructor will be using it. We have to have the ability to have this dialogue. We need to make sure that we understand what we're talking, or what these terms mean when we actually use them. We want to realize the importance that statistics plays in our daily lives. Give some importance as to why we're doing this to begin with. We need to establish that working terminology which allow for a technical discussion, which is essentially very much like the very first learning objective that I listed there. Understand the different scales used in the measurement of data. In the next chapter, or in the very near future here, we will be talking about actually gathering data. And when we gather data, we use what's known as measurement scales that we assign to each variable. And understanding those measurement scales is pretty important in helping us later on to determine the appropriate analytical tool to use. We want to understand the different types of variables used in statistical analysis. First of all, let's talk for a moment about why we should study statistics to begin with. Why should we be here, other than to mark off a checkbox and a piece of paper someplace that says you can get your degree? This type of course actually serves much more important function than just simply checking off a box someplace. The study of statistics is actually the understanding of data analysis, and the results of data analysis touches our daily lives. Everything from interest rates. How are interest rates adjusted? It's as a result of the collection and analysis of data, what's happened in the economy. You hear employment rates all the time. You hear a lot of discussion about unemployment rates, particularly when it's getting close to election time. That's very sensitive to politicians. What's the employment rate? Well, again, it's information that's collected and analyzed, and this rate that is come up with. Stocks and bonds, when should you buy? When should you sell? If you have somebody managing a mutual fund for you, well, how does this person make that decision whether they should buy now, whether they should transfer those funds into a money market and hold there for a while, they should jump into the stocks and buy or sell? Or, how do they make those decisions? Well, it's all based on collecting data, what's happening in the market now, what's happening around the world, because all kinds of things that happen worldwide can inflect or can have an effect on the stock market. So it's a collection of all that information, an analysis, a synthesis of all the information, and then a decision-making process. Medical research. Data analysis is used a lot in medical research. How is it that they know that if they take this particular drug or this new treatment for perhaps a type of cancer or a new form of pain medication for headaches, how is it that they know that this treatment or this pain medication works better than the other one did, or at least as good, or as good but with less side effects? How do they know that? Well, it's because of the data that's collected, the analysis of that data, and the conclusion that the data brings you to. So, with that in mind, about why we should be studying statistics to begin with, let's take a look at the next video. And the next video in this series is going to actually cover some of those basic terms and definitions that's going to be important to you to understand what's going on and be successful in the course.